Excel has three functions that are commonly used for splitting text that's in one cell into fragments. They are the left, right, and mid functions. The left function extracts whatever number of characters you want from the leftmost value in a cell. So for this cell, if we want to just pull out the area code, we would use the left function. We start like this, equals left, open parenthesis. We need the text, that's the original value, comma, the number of characters we want to pull out. So that's 3, because we only want the area code. Close parentheses and enter. So now we have 905. You'll notice here that the number of characters is in square brackets, which means it's optional. If we don't include the number of characters, the left value only extracts the leftmost character, so the very first one. All right, but we do want the area code, so we'll keep it at 3 characters. Now we can copy this formula to the other cells, and we have all the area codes. Let's jump to the right function. It's pretty similar to left, except that it starts counting from the rightmost character. So if we wanted the last 4 digits of the phone number, we'd use the right function. And that's equals, right, open parenthesis, the original text, comma, the number of characters we want to extract, and that's 4. Close parentheses, and we have the last 4 digits. Just like the left function, the second argument is optional, and if we omit it, then the right function only takes the very last character. Let's keep our number 4 here and copy to the other rows. Let's spend a little more time on the mid function because it has more arguments, so it needs a little more explanation. First off, all the arguments are required. You'll notice there are no square brackets here. We start with the text, that's the original value. And then we need the start number. That is, what character number do we want to start extracting from? In this case, we know it's the 4th argument because the first 3 characters would have been the area code. So we want to start with the 4th character. And how many characters do we want to extract? We want 3. Close parentheses and hit enter. So now we have the middle and we can copy to the remaining cells. So you just learned how to use all 3 functions, left, right, and mid. Now this example was easy because the original text string is of a fixed length. The phone numbers are all 10 characters long, and we know exactly how many digits make up each part of the phone number. But what if we had a situation like this one? Here we want to separate first and last names into separate columns. Obviously, they're of different lengths, so there's more than one problem to be solved here. Whenever this happens, we know that we'll likely be embedding or nesting one function within another. Now, remember that for the left function, we'll want to know how many characters to extract. The space character is a good marker because we'll know the first name ended just before the space character. So now we need a way to identify the position number of the character just before the space. So let's take it step by step. Let's search for the space character. We use the search function, open parentheses. What text do we want to find? We want a space. So double quotes, space, double quotes. That's a text we're searching for. Where do we want to search? Within this text. And it asks for the start number. That is, what character number do we want to start searching from? Here we want to start from the very first character. So since that character is optional and the first character is the default, we don't need that third argument for the search. This tells us that our space character is the 5th character within this text string. So we'll want to stop just before. So one character just before the space is where we want to stop, which means we just found out the number of characters to be extracted with our left function. So let's wrap the left function around what we just found out. We can hit F2 to get inside the cell and just start wrapping the left function around it. So right after the equal sign, we type left, open parentheses, here's the text. And we already found out the number of characters, so we can just close our parentheses here. And that's how we get the first name in the first row, and we can copy to the others. To pull out the last names, do we need the left, right, or mid function? Of course, we need the right function, but again, we need to find the space to figure out where to stop. Now, we already found out that using the search function tells us that the space is in the fifth character, but that's the fifth character from the left. Remember that the right function starts counting from the right. So how do we find out the position number if we were counting from right to left? We could find out the length of the entire string and subtract the position number of the space character from that number. So let's do that. We can find out the length of the entire string with the len function. So len, here's the text. So this text string is 14 characters long. And to find the position number of the space character, we already know that we can use the search, double quotes, space, and within this text. So the resulting number is 9, which tells us that this is the length of the last name. All we need to do now is wrap the write function right around this value and use this as the number of characters to be extracted. So let's get inside that cell and type the word write, open parenthesis. Here's the text, and we already know the number of characters because we did that calculation. Close parentheses, and we've got the last name here. Once we double click, we'll have everyone's last name. The final trick for today is using the mid function to extract a value that isn't really in the middle of a string. In this list, we want to drop the leading four-letter code for the species and only retain their common name. The first temptation is to think that we should use the write function, since the fragment we want is at the end of the string. But remember that with the write function, we need to know exactly how many characters we want to extract. And we don't, since all the animal names are of different lengths. But the fact that each common name starts at the eighth character is key. We notice that the species code is 4 characters long, followed by a space, dash, space. That takes 7 characters. So each common name starts with the eighth character. But now we do need to know how many characters to extract. Are we stuck again? Not really. We can just use a really large number that's longer than the text length. We can use 100, 1,000, 5,000, any number that's long enough to catch everything all the way to the end. So let's do that with the mid function, equals mid, open parenthesis. Here's the text we want to extract from. The starting number will be the eighth character. And what number of characters? We can use 500. Close parenthesis and hit enter. That's the common name of the first animal, double click, and we have them all. And that's that. Using functions isn't the only method to split data, but it's definitely helpful in certain situations and may in fact be your best option with some older versions of Excel.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.